an amazing story of lost and found, spanning 1,000 miles, 5 states, and more than a year of not knowing.
A military family in Kentucky says their dog was stolen out of their backyard in 2011. Then 2 weeks ago, the dog showed up at a shelter in Española. Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendez introduces us to Puka and the reunion in the making.
If dogs could talk, Puka would probably have one incredible story to tell.
I would ask her, how did you get here, Puka?
That is the 1,200-mile question. At first, it seemed Puka was just another Chiweeny in Española.
Somebody saw her wandering and that she was taken in by a woman to the shelter.
Melanie Lopez wound up taking Puka in, her 29th foster dog. But this would be no ordinary foster. Turns out, a military family all the way in Kentucky has been missing Puka. A year and a half ago, she was snatched out of their yard.
It's a really scary feeling. They're part of your family, so it's like losing a child.
Calle Bonita wound up being a long way away from Puka's original home. Just how far? They were able to figure it out thanks to Puka's microchip buried inside her body.
Oh, like that.
Puka is now living the life with the Lopez family, but little does she know, she's about to set out on yet another cross-country trip. Come Wednesday, her original owners will fly from Kentucky to Albuquerque to take her home again.
I can't even imagine how excited to get to see her, like this, that you want Wednesday to come here really soon.
We may never know how or why Puka came here in the first place, but like so many journeys, the road less traveled has made all the difference. And it looks like Puka's road will end where it first began.
It just shows that there's always hope. Even a year later, a year and a half later, you never know when your dog may turn out.
In Española, Tanya Mendez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Quite a story. Puka's original owner, Mandy Smith, is able to fly here thanks to a local pet advocate who donated frequent flyer miles. Workers at the Española Valley Humane Society say when they told her about the news over the phone, Smith, of course, was thrilled, saying the day they lost Puka was the worst day of their lives.